for at this time, bring your tithes and offering, the children, the ladies, and the men, please.
Worthy is the Lamb. sickness, no more madness, no more pain. When we all see Jesus face to face.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Give them boys a hand. I'm telling you what.
Amen. Tony, I want you to sing what you sang Wednesday night. If y'all find that song, please. Brother Billy, you might want to help him. Come on over here. We can see you, Brother Tony, right here. Amen.
God walks the dark hill. I see the byway. He walks on the billows of life's troubled sea. He walks through the cold, dark night, shadows of midnight. God walks the dark hills just to guide you and me. God walks the dark hills. Rivers to valleys. God walks the dark hills, 'cause he loves you and me. God walks the dark hills to guide my footsteps.
Together, will you please all stand together? Give God a good hand clap. Thank you, Brother Tony. Amen. Amen. You ought to feel what you sing. Praise the Lord. Amen. God is so good. 3 weeks we've been studying, looking together. 3 weeks ago I told you how to have victory, how to respond to the pandemic, things that are happening in this world of uncertainty. But we have certainty. We have absoluteness as believers. I remind you not to panic. So many people are panicking. We ought to pursue God. He'll reward us. Remember those things. We ought to pray. Keep praying. Pray without ceasing. And what an opportunity we have to proclaim the gospel. When everybody don't know which way to turn, we have the answer. Say amen. Amen. And last week I gave you 5 things to keep you strong in the time in which we live now. Remember, I encourage you, you want to write them down every morning. Seek God early in the morning before you do anything else. 2, we talked about it, a quiet time that we could get along with God, hear from the Lord, hear what God has to say. Then we talked about being around people, friends who encourage you, who know how you feel, who understand ministry and your life, and you can identify with them. They not dare to discourage you, but to encourage you. Also, we reminded you that we need to read good material, good resources, the Word of God that will lift us up and encourage us, not spend all day long watching lying television, but reading the Word of God. And then we got to always remember, acknowledge God. God's still on the throne, say amen. So we're going to look today from the Word of God, and I just ask the Lord to lead in a direction in which we should go. And we're going to go to Joshua chapter 1 today, the Old Testament, and we're going to talk about following the leader. You know, God's people needs leadership. Amen. And I want to say to you today, church, I'm glad you're here, but those who are not here, you need to get on to church. Get on back to the house of God. I don't know what you're waiting on now, but your governor said it's okay. The president said it's okay. And the preacher said it's been okay. You ought to get on back to the house of God where we can be together. Don't it feel good to be in the house of the Lord today? It's good to be in God's house. And so when we come to this chapter, in Joshua chapter 1, we see that God's meek messenger, Moses, has died. And God raised up another man to lead them. We're going to look together and see what God's word said. If you love the word, say amen. Joshua 1, verse 1. Now after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spake unto Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' minister, saying, Moses, my servant is dead. Now therefore rise and go over this Jordan, thou and all this people, unto the land which I do give to them, even the children of Israel. Don't forget what God said now. Every place at the foot, your soul, your foot, shall tread upon. In other words, everywhere you walk that I have given to you, as I said, I will give it to Moses. From the wilderness unto this Lebanon, even to the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and to all the great sea toward the going down the sun shall be your border. There should not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life. As I was with Moses, I will be with thee. I will not fail thee nor forsake thee. Be strong and of good courage, for unto this people shalt thou divide an inheritance, that land which I swear unto the fathers to give to them. Notice what he said in verse 7. Only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest observe to do according to all the law which Moses, my servant, commanded thee. Turn not from the right or to the hand or to the left, that thou mayest prosper wherever thou goest. This book of the law shall not depart from thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that's written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. Have I not commanded thee? Be strong and of good courage. Be not afraid, neither be dismayed, for the Lord thy God is with thee everywhere you go. How many know you can't hide from God? Everywhere you go, God called Joshua. Then we see God commissioned Joshua. Then we understand the word of God that he rewarded Joshua. We need to seek the Lord. Then we see that we have God's comfort. Wherever we go, God said, I've already given the things to you that you need. How many know God's word is a strong word? I love what the Bible says, the word of God in Isaiah 54:17, where it says, no weapon that's formed against you shall prosper. Not one word. Amen. And every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment, thou shalt condemn. This is the heritage, the success of the servants of the Lord. If you're a servant of the Lord, say amen. Then you look into Scripture, God's guidance. God guides his servants. We're not just wandering around in uncertainty. God gives us guidance. Then you see there in verse 8, success is always meditating on the Word of God. If you were to learn to be a preacher today, you could take these verses and expository, just write it down, and I'm just giving you a sermon outline. Just do what God says. And how many know that God's a keeper? No man's able to pluck us out of the hands of God. Wherever we go, God keeps us. What a mighty God we serve. You may be seated. Father, we thank you today. We praise you for this word. Father, we ask you, God, today to help us to submit to your leadership. God, we want to follow you, not the world, not man. Our desire above all things, God, is that you lead us and that, Lord, that we're able to surrender and submit to your leadership. Thank you for this message today before we even preach it. Thank you for the things we've already heard and for who you are. In Jesus' name, amen. You know, the Bible said, first of all, that Moses, the servant of God, had died and that God raised up Joshua to take over and be the leader of the people of Israel. How many know the word of God will never die? The grass will wither, the flower will fade, but the word of God will stand forever and forever and forever. We see here that Joshua became God's new leader. It was a new beginning for the people of God, and Joshua was God's called general. He was a leader to lead the people into the promised land. God's appointed place. God appoints us to walk a successful life. What we want to think about is an appointed place, the will of God for our life. Joshua was born in slavery. He was born when they were in Egypt, and those rough years prepared him for leadership. Have you noted preparing to serve the Lord don't mean everything's been easy for you? That you learn by your mistakes, your downs, the hard times in your life, it prepares you to be a leader. Joshua also means Hoshea, which means salvation, is a type of Christ. And in the Hebrew, Jehovah is salvation, meaning that Joshua was a form like the Lord Jesus Christ, a deliverer. He was used by God to deliver the people into the promised land. Joshua also was a slave born in Egypt. Also, he was a soldier. Joshua was with Moses when they defeated the Amalekites 2 months after Israel's exodus from Egypt. He was also, we see his background or resume, he was a servant of the Lord. And Joshua 1:1 said he was called Moses' minister. He served the Lord. Here is where you start. As a believer, it's divine leadership. You start in serving. We talk about serving. We talk about preparing yourself to be a leader. First, you've got to serve other people. You've got to be able to minister to other people. You've got to be able to wash other people's feet. You've got to be able to hold other people's hands. You've got to be able to love all people. You've got to be a servant to all people, whether they saved or lost. It's a beginning of preparing yourself to be a leader. Joshua accompanied Moses to the mount for worship, but also for instructions from the Lord. He was always going up with Moses. You know, when you prepare yourself to be a leader, you're always moving upward, never downward. Joshua also was by Moses' side as he judged the people of God. Remember when they built a golden calf because they wanted to have some kind of object to worship. And they were all dancing around the golden calf and worshiping idols. See, and there was God using Moses to judge the people of God, and Joshua was right there by his side. We understand here this leader that God raised up. He was a warrior. He was a worshiper. But he knew the word of God. These are the qualifications of leadership. That you are a warrior. You're able to fight and pray and stand against the enemy, the things of the world, and believe what God's word says. He was a warrior, not a wimp. Amen. He was also a man who was willing to serve the Lord, and he always was anxious to hear what God had to say. So you see here that Joshua was a slave, a soldier, a servant, but also remember, he was a visionary. He was a man. He became a spy. Remember that Moses sent out Joshua and Caleb to go out and spy the promised land. And they came back and they were excited about it. See, it was a place of plenteous things and wonderful things, and we can go and do it. But remember when they came back, that out of the 12 that they sent out, 10 of them said, no, let's don't go. It's too large. There are giants in the land, and we can't go and we can't take this land. It was a spirit of fear that took over these 10 spies, but not so for Joshua and Caleb. They loved the Lord. They trusted God. And they would encourage the people to move into the land. It was divine leadership, moving forward by faith. And sadly, we know the truth here. They listened to the 10 faithless spies, and their rebellion delayed the conquest into Canaan for 40 years. How many know that unfaithfulness would delay you to the blessings of God? Y'all gonna help me preach today? You're going to be faithful to the Lord to be able to receive from the Lord. Joshua and Caleb trusted God and believed God. But notice, while they were delayed, God was using this time to prepare a man named Joshua, a type of a savior, a type of the church today, a deliverer, a leader. Joshua was also successor. Through the battles in the wilderness, Moses would train Joshua and encourage Joshua. Don't be afraid. Don't be fearful of the enemy. Remember, Joshua was a slave, a soldier, a servant, a spy. He was a successor. He was called by God, but he was not perfect in himself. And nobody is. Like Moses, he made many mistakes. You know, people today are looking for perfection. And mankind, you're not going to find anybody perfect. It'll take you about 1 second to examine anybody and find everybody has faults. Matter of fact, the Bible said we've all sinned and come short of the glory of God. So his strength and the call to minister wouldn't be because of who Joshua was. It's because God called him. It makes the world of difference. The secret of Joshua's success was he had faith in the word of God. He had a spiritual ear. He desired to hear what God said. And the people believed him and trusted him, and they followed him. The word here, the commandments, the promise of God, they made him strong. Remember what God said to Joshua, be strong and be very courageous. If we're going to be leaders in this time and day in which we live now, in this such a time that we have around us, we got to be in the word of God, listen to what God says, and be strong and very courageous. Don't give in to the mindset of the world, the mindset of the crowd. We should be people hungry for the word and full of the word of God, that we can be strong in the Lord. So we talked about the background of Joshua. So let's move on to what it says in chapter 1 here. And always remember, God encourages his leaders. And when he causes them, when he calls them, he would encourage them. It's not always encouraging when you look in what you see, but God would encourage you. You got to remember, you look to the Lord, not the people. You don't look to what people are doing. You look what God's doing. And if God's called you to a ministry, he will always remind you where he called you from. He'll always remind you what you used to be. He always take you back to that time, that place, that moment where God set you aside and God called you. And you always remember it, what man that called you, or organization that called you, or even a church that called you. But God himself called you. And you got to know that you've been called by God. So notice here the encouragement from God's commission in verse 1 and 2. But notice verse 2 primarily. Moses, my servant, he said, God said to Moses, he's dead. Now therefore, arise and go over this Jordan, thou and all this people into the land. Listen what God is saying, which I do give unto them, even the children of Israel. God said, go ahead, Moses. I want you to lead these people. I want you to go across this Jordan. I want you to go ahead and enjoy what I've already given you. You know, God has already prepared for us in Christ Jesus in the faithful, submitted life, the abundant life. All we got to do is enjoy it and serve God and obey the word of God and live in it. Notice here this encouragement. Joshua was commissioned to lead the new generation, those who didn't die and 40 years in the wilderness, into a new challenge to enter and to conquer the promised land, battle after battle after battle. Some people get to preaching about the promised land and they get to jumping and shouting and thinking the promised land is a picture of heaven, and it's not. The promised land is that we got victory in the Lord, and in this life we're going to have victory, but we're going to have battles. After battles, you read the scripture, they went from one battle to another battle. They would win, they would lose, they would get up, they would get down, and God would always give them the victory. That's the picture there of Canaan. God always is looking for someone to go and someone to do. Joshua was God called, therefore he was God sent, which is a picture today of the church. Don't forget now, God has called you if you're saved. And when God calls you, he sends you. God don't call you to sit at home. God don't call you to sit around on your blessed assurance. God calls everybody who's called is sent by God. When you leave here today, God is sending you out of the church building to be the church in the world. God's commissioned you and called you by the glory of God. Somebody help me preach today. Most leaders today, pastors, are criticized. They persecuted, attacked simply because, like Joshua, they had a divine commission to lead a ministry into the fields of victory and conquest. God commissioned Joshua to achieve three things. Listen very carefully. He said, Joshua, I want you to lead the people into the promised land. How many know sheep need a shepherd? The people of God needs a leader. And God can call anybody he wants to call to lead his sheep. Amen? Anybody who stands up behind the pulpit and struts in their own ability and who they are, they're a long way from understanding who God is and who they are. It's amazing that God would call any human being to preach this divine word. It's amazing that God would call anybody to lead other people in the way of the Lord. God calls leaders to lead the people. And the people of God need divine leadership. Would you say amen? Also, he called them not only to lead the people into the land, he also called them to defeat the enemy. He didn't call them to be defeated. He called them to defeat the enemy. How do we defeat the enemy? By fighting a good fight of faith. You got to have faith. Not just sometime, not just when there is no pandemic, not when there is a remedy or vaccination. You need to fight now. Be a good fighter. And keep on fighting. Don't recess on God and take a break. It's a time to get together, pray together, be together, and fight a good fight of faith. Also, he called Joshua to lead them to claim their inheritance, to rejoice in the Lord. You know what their inheritance was? Success. God didn't save you to be a failure. God saved you to be successful. Now, that don't mean that you're driving the biggest car, the biggest house, the biggest bank account, the most most highly ranked position in the community. Success is knowing God. That's the inheritance you have as a believer. That you know who God is and know that God is still God and God is still in control and God's still on the throne and God is very present with us. And everything that God said that we are and have, we have in the Lord Jesus Christ. Somebody say amen in the house of God today. God could have called an angel, but he didn't. He chose a man to give him power he needed to get the job done. He filled Joshua with the power of God the Holy Spirit. You know, after years of preaching, you find out things about people. The only thing a God-called person can do is lead those who are willing to be led and teach those who are willing to be taught and to win those who are willing to be won. And if you're not in that category, ain't nothing I can do to help you. And ain't much help you can get. Amen? You've got to be divinely led by God, by the Word of God, not by an individual, but what did God say? Amen? Come on. We've got to be taught the Word of God. And the only way you can ever be saved is by the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Remember, Joshua was the type of Christ, the captain of our salvation, who has already won the victory. We're not looking for victory. You know, the church today has recessed back as though that we've been defeated. The church today is acting like they in the retreat position. The Bible is telling Joshua, it's telling us today that we need to move forward. They keep on moving forward in our faith. They keep moving forward, not to hibernate and hide, but God says we to be salt and light, and we to keep moving forward because God has commissioned us. And the commission's not over until the shout. Also, in Joshua's encouragement was from the promise of God. Look what 3 through verse 6 says, for every place, everywhere your foot goes, I said unto Moses, I give it to him, I'm going to give it to you. Even he began to give the borders all the inheritance. In verse 5, he said that there's not one man that can stand before thee all the days of your life. Now, he didn't say just when you are doing good or when things are easy and smooth. He said the good days and the bad days. Every day of your life, I'm going to be there with you. Therefore, he said, be strong and very courageous. Didn't the Bible say in Ephesians 6:10, finally, my brother, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. God says it very quickly in his promises that he was going to be with us, just as he has been with Joshua. Now, since Joshua had a threefold task to do, to perform, God gave him three special promises and one for each calling that he gave him. First of all, God would enable him, verse 3 through 4. I'm going to give you the power. See, you can't be a leader, be a Christian, be what God wants you to be in your own enablement. It's by the power of God. I'm going to give you power to cross this river and claim the land. See, we got to go over to the other side by the power of God. Number 2, in verse 5, he said, I'm going to give you power to defeat the enemy. That's the promise of God. God said, I'm going to defeat them. You can't defeat man. God defeats man for you. And in number 3, verse 6, God promised to help Joshua to divide the land and to each tribe in their inheritance. See, God loves his people. And God loves his children equally. I'm going to make sure everybody is successful. Not just the leaders of the tribe. Everybody in the tribe is going to be successful. That's what the inheritance is to the people of God. Now notice here in verse 6 that God didn't tell Joshua how he was going to accomplish the promise. Why did he not tell him? Because we must remember, church, that as God's people, we are to live by faith in God's promises and not ask for explanations. How are you going to do it, God? We're not to ask God how he's going to do it. Because how he does it is higher than we can ever imagine. You think about your own life and you look around. How did that happen? Where did that come from? It came from God. And it's so great and mighty even listen, we can't explain it, and we should never ask God to explain it. When we trust God's promise by faith, He will always give us direction. Didn't the Bible say, trust in the Lord with all your heart, lean not to your own understanding, all your ways acknowledge Him, and God will give you direction. We just got to trust the Lord. God had already given Israel the promised land, and all they had to do was just by faith step out and get it. That's what salvation is. You just got to reach out and receive it from the Lord Jesus Christ. And this lesson is for every believer, all of God's people. God has given us all spiritual blessings in Christ Jesus, and we got to step up and step out and claim them for the glory of God. Remember what God said in Revelation 3:8. I've opened the door for you. I set before you an open door, and nobody's going to close it. See, God's opened the door here for ministry. Listen, God ain't closed the door. Let me tell you something. And no man's going to close it. Why should we allow man to close the house of God? God has opened the door. All God ever requires from us to acclaim His promise is to be obedient and to be faithful to God. So God promised to Joshua, I'm going to give you power to cross over. I'm going to give you power to defeat the enemy. He gives it to us. And I will also give you power to know how to divide the land. See, anything you need as a believer, God will give you instruction. Also notice here how Joshua was encouraged from God's word. If you love the word, say amen. He said, verse 7 and 8, only be strong and very courageous. You may observe according to all which Moses, my servant, commanded thee, what Moses said. Turn not from the right hand to the left, that you may prosper wherever you go. He said, this book, the law, shall not depart from your mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that you may observe everything that's written therein. For then shalt thou make your way prosperous, and then shalt thou have good success. Man, if everybody would take God's word to heart and believe what God said, it would cause you to be a successful Christian. Joshua's strength and his courage came from meditating on the word of God and believing the promises of God and obeying the precepts, the teachings of the word of God. In verse 8, God told Joshua to meditate on the word day and night, not just Sunday. Day and night, every day. He didn't mention a particular day. He said every day meditate on the word of God day and night. And the word meditate, in the Hebrew, it means to mutter. It means to the Jewish people in those days, they would practice aloud the word of God. And they would talk about it to themselves and to one another. And someone said, if you don't talk to your Bible and speak the word of God, it might not even speak to you. Sometimes you just need to speak the words of God. What God said. What did God say? This plague, this pestilence won't come nigh to your dwelling. I'm going to hold you like a hen holds its chicks under my wings. I'm going to protect you. I'm going to protect you in the front. I'm going to protect you on the side. And I'm going to protect you in the rear. You just got to speak the word of God and enjoy the success and the blessings of the holy word of God. Somebody ought to say amen. Listen very carefully. Prosperity and success for the believer are not measured by what the world's standards are.